Dear students, in the previous class we were discussed about complementary function of a linear differential equation with constant coefficients. In that we were finding complementary function when auxiliary equation has n distinct roots. Suppose an auxiliary equation has n distinct roots that are m1, m2, so on up to mn. At that time, complementary function can be written as y is equal to c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x till so on up to cn e power mnx, where c1, c2, so on up to cn are arbitrary constants. In today's class, we will discuss about the case 2, that is when the auxiliary equation has equal roots or repeated roots. Suppose auxiliary equation f of m is equal to 0 has two repeated roots. Say m is equal to b comma b. At that time, complementary function can be written as y is equal to c1 plus c2 x into e power b, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant. Suppose if two repeated roots b I will consider, at that time complementary function can be written as like this. Suppose these repeated roots are thrice marked, b is repeated three times, at that time complementary function can be written as y is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into e power bx. Suppose 4 times it is repeated, so at that time y is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus c4x power 3 into e power bx, where c1, c2, c3, c4 are arbitrary constants. Next we shall discuss about the case number 3, that is when the auxiliary equation has complex roots. When the auxiliary equation has a complex roots. Suppose f of m is equal to 0 has a complex root alpha plus I into beta. Then alpha minus I into beta is also a solution of f of m is equal to 0. Suppose f of m is equal to 0 is an auxiliary equation, then alpha plus I into beta is a complex root of this f of m is equal to 0. Then alpha minus I into beta is also a solution or root of f of m is equal to 0. Then the part of complementary function can be written as c1 into e power alpha plus I into beta plus c2 into e to the power alpha minus I into beta. So further I will simplify, that is c1 e power alpha into e power I beta plus c2 e power alpha, here alpha plus I beta into x, alpha minus I beta into x. So alpha x into e power I into beta x, c2 into e power alpha x into e power minus I beta x. So further we can write this as, observe that both the term e power alpha x is common, so I will take that one outside e power alpha x. So we left with c1 into e power I beta x plus c2 into e power minus I beta x. Now we apply the Euler formula here, so that is e power alpha x I will write as it is. Here c1 into, this can be written as by using the Euler formula, cos beta x plus I into sin beta x plus c2 into cos beta x minus I into sin beta x. That is equal to again x, c2 cos beta x. So from these two terms I will take cos beta x outside. So we left with c1 plus c2 into cos beta x plus from the second term now c1 I sin beta x, c2 minus I sin beta x. So I will take outside here sin beta x. So we left with c1 minus c2 into I into sin beta x. Further, this is equal to e power alpha x into c1 plus c2. I will write a into cos beta x plus c1 minus c2 into I will write b into sin beta x. So therefore, complementary function, when the auxiliary equation has the complex root, is given by e power alpha x into a cos beta x plus b sin beta x, where a and b are arbitrary constants. So now I shall solve some of the problems. So problem number one. First problem we shall solve. D squared minus 3D plus 2 into y is equal to 0. D squared minus 3D plus 2 into y is equal to 0. I will call this as equation number 1 now. First observe that given equation 1 is of the form f of d into y is equal to 0. Then the auxiliary equation of equation number 1 is of the form f of m is equal to 0. So that can be written as m squared minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. We shall simplify this one. We will get here m squared. When we multiply, we should get 2. When we add, we should get minus 3. So that 2 and 1, so minus 2 and minus 1, minus 2m minus m plus 2 is equal to 0. So take m outside, m minus 2, take minus 1 outside, m minus 2. So then m minus 2 into m minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, roots are now m is equal to 2 comma 1. Observe that here distinct roots, at that time general solution or otherwise complementary function of equation number 1 is given by y is equal to c1 into e power 2x plus c2 into e power x, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant. We may write this one as c1 into e power x plus c2 into e to the power 2x. We can take 1 first or 2 first. Let us solve the next problem. Solve d minus 1 squared into y is equal to 0. Solve d minus 1 whole square into y is equal to 0. Given equation is of the form f of d into y is equal to 0, and auxiliary equation is of the form f of m is equal to 0, and I will call given equation as equation number 1. Auxiliary equation is of the form f of m is equal to 0. So f of m can be written as here m minus 1 square is equal to 0. Or otherwise we may write here f of m minus 1 whole square it is. So m minus 1 into m minus 1 is equal to 0. So therefore roots are now m is equal to 1 comma 1. Observe that here repeated roots. Given auxiliary equation has repeated roots, so complementary function or otherwise solution of equation number 1 can be written as y is equal to c1 plus c2x, because only two repeated roots here, c1 c1x plus c2x into e power bx is the formula. So we may write y is equal to c1 plus c2x into e power b is 1 here, so e power x, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant. That has to be written, okay? So that carries the 1 marks. Next, let us solve the third problem here. Solve d plus 2 whole square. Solve d plus 2 whole square into d minus 3 into y is equal to 0. Again, observe that given equation is of the form f of d into y is equal to 0, and I will call the given equation as equation number 1 here, and auxiliary equation is of the form f of m is equal to 0, so that can be written as here m plus 2 whole square m minus 3 is equal to 0. Now m plus 2 whole square it is there, so I can write this one as m plus 2 into m plus 2 into m minus 3 is equal to 0. So therefore the roots are observed at minus 2, minus 2 and plus 3. So 3, minus 2 and minus 2. Here two roots are repeated twice. So therefore we can write the complementary function or solution of equation number 1 as y is equal to c1, first I will write this one, this is the distinct actually, c1 e power 3x plus, these two are repeated now, that's why I will write c2 plus c3x into e power minus 2x, where c1, c2 and c3 are arbitrary constant. Observe that here 3 is repeated, 3 is only once it is, so we will write first. Otherwise, we may write first this one and at the end we may write this one, okay? So, 3 is first root here, so I will write c1 e power 3x plus minus 2 is repeated twice. So, we have to write this one c2 plus c3x into e to the power minus 2x. Suppose now, minus 2 may be repeated thrice, so at that time you can write this one as c2 plus c3x plus c3x square, c4x square e power minus 2x we will write. So next problem number 4. Solve d cube minus 3d square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. Solve d cube minus 3d square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. Given equation is of the form f of d into y is equal to 0. To find the solution or otherwise complementary function of equation number 1, we shall first consider the auxiliary equation is of the form f of m is equal to 0. Now f of m can be written as m cube minus 3m square plus 4 is equal to 0. M cube minus 3m square plus 4 is equal to 0. So first we shall find the root of this auxiliary equation. By inspection we can say that m is equal to minus 1 is the first root. Minus 1 cube minus 3, so plus 4. Okay. M is equal to minus 1 is the first root. So therefore now we shall divide this m cube minus 3m square plus 4 by m plus, by the factor m plus 1. So we shall divide this m cube minus 3m square plus 4 by the factor now m plus 1. So the first term in the quotient is m square. So multiply this by m square now, m cube plus m square. So we shall get here, when subtracting second equation will change its sign now. So these will get cancelled. Here it is minus m square plus 4. Next again divide, second term of the quotient is minus 4m. So that is minus 4m square minus 4m. Again, subtract, second term will, second equation will change this sign. These two will get cancels. Minus 4m will be now plus 4m and plus 4. Again, divide, so we will get plus 4. 4m plus 4, so remainder will be 0. Therefore, m cube minus 3m squared plus 4 can be written as now m plus 1 into quotient term is m squared minus 4m plus 2. That is equal to 0. Further simplify, m plus 1 and this can be written as now m minus 2 whole square is equal to 0. Observe that m squared minus 4m plus 4 can be written as m minus 2 whole square. So again, this can be written as m plus 1 into m minus 2 into m minus 2, that is equal to 0. So therefore roots are m is equal to minus 1 plus 2 and plus 2. So now complementary function of given equation number 1 can be written as y is equal to, I will write this as first now, c1 e power minus x plus c2 e c2 plus c3 x into e power 2x. C1 e power minus x plus c2 plus c3x into e power 2x, where c1, c2, c3 are arbitrary constants. Let us solve the next one more important problem. Problem number 5. M squared minus 2m plus 2 whole square is equal to 0. This is because by using the formula a plus b plus c whole square is equal to a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. We can simplify by using this formula, we will obtain this one. M square minus 2m plus 2 whole square is equal to 0. Next, we can write this one as now m square minus 2m plus 2 into m square minus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. So we shall find the root m plus 2 is equal to 0. So we have the now root for these now by using the formula minus b plus or minus b square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So for this we will get now 1 plus or minus I. Again for this also we will get 1 plus or minus I, same repeated complex roots here. So therefore we can write the solution as a, or otherwise complementary function y is equal to, in general for the complex root it is e power alpha x into c1 cos x cos, sorry, a into cos beta x plus b into sin beta x. Now we will have repeated roots, that's why we may write this one as e power alpha x into a plus cx into cos beta x plus b plus dx into sin beta x. Now substitute what is alpha and beta, so we will get e power alpha is 1 here, x into a plus cx into cos beta is also 1 plus b plus dx into sin x. So this one is the complementary function for the given equation number 1. Let us solve the next problem. Sixth one. D square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. D square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. I will call this as equation number 1. First observe that given equation is of the form f of d into y is equal to 0, as well as consider the auxiliary equation is of the form f of m is equal to 0. So that is m square plus 4 is equal to 0. So we can write m square is equal to minus 4. M is equal to plus or minus 2i. Observe that m is equal to plus or minus 2i. So now we have complex roots. So at that time complementary function is y is equal to e power alpha x into a cos x plus b sin x. So here alpha is 0, so e power 0 x is 1. So a into cos, here it is beta x. Beta is 2 here, cos 2x plus b into sin 2x. So that is the complementary function for given equation number 1.